Good morning friends, welcome to the series of IC38 IRDA agent exam. Today we are going to learn some important question answers from recent exam. Dear friends, please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed, and don't forget to click on like button and bell button so that you will get notification about my latest videos. Let us see what is IC38 IRDA agent exam new syllabus. As for new syllabus of IC38 IRDA exam, there are 21 chapters, and these 21 chapters are divided into 3 sections, that is section 1 common chapters, introduction to insurance, and section 2 life insurance. Section 3 deals with health insurance. As we know, this exam consists of 50 questions and it will be online mode, and the total marks allotted is 50 marks. To pass this exam, one has to score minimum 18 marks, and the time duration of this test is 60 minutes. Let us see the syllabus. As per new syllabus, under section 1, there is chapter 1, introduction to insurance, 2, customer service, 3, grievance redressal mechanism, 4, regulatory aspects of insurance agents, 5, legal principles of an insurance contract. Dear friends, section 2, life insurance, deals with what life insurance involves, financial planning, life insurance products 1 and 2, chapter 10, applications of life insurance, followed by chapter 11, pricing and valuation in life insurance, chapter 12, documentation, proposal stage, documentation, policy condition 1, policy condition 2, then chapter 15, underwriting, followed by 16, payments under a life insurance policy. Dear friends, next, section 3 deals with health insurance, that is chapter 17, introduction to health insurance, insurance documentation, health insurance products, health insurance underwriting. Chapter 21 deals with health insurance claims. Dear friends, as per new syllabus, out of 50 questions, it is expected to get about 15 to 20 questions from section 1, that is from common chapters of introduction, and whereas 20 to 25 questions from life insurance section 2. At the same time, from section 3, that is health insurance, it is expected to get 10 to 15 questions. Dear friends, let us see. Dear friends, today we are going to learn about introduction to insurance, recently asked very important questions. Let us see the questions. Question number 1. Which among the following is the regulator for the insurance industry in India? Which is the insurance regulator? Dear friends, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, IRDAI, is the regulator of for the insurance industry in India. Dear friends, for banks, it is RBI, Reserve Bank of India, whereas for all insurance companies, life, non-life, health insurance companies, all comes under IRDAI regulations. Next question, which among the following is a secondary burden of risk? Secondary burden of risk, what is secondary burden? Setting aside reserves as a provision for meeting potential losses in the future is known as secondary burden. Dear friends, burdens are two types, primary and secondary burden. To meet this, it is best advisable to go for risk transfer by taking insurance. Dear friends, here the question is, which among the following is a secondary burden of risk? Secondary burden is setting aside reserves as a provision for meeting potential losses in the future is known as secondary burden. Business interruption cost is not correct. Goods damaged cost is not correct. Hospitalization cost is not correct. Setting aside reserves as a provision is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 3. Which among the following is a method of risk transfer? What is the method of risk transfer? Insurance, friends. Insurance is a method of transfer, risk transfer. Bank FD, no. Equity shares, no. Real estate, no. The answer is insurance. Next, question number 4. Which among the following scenarios warrants insurance? The sole breadwinner of a family might die untimely is correct answer, friends. A person may lose his wallet, stock prices may fall drastically, a house may lose value due to natural wear and tear. No, the answer is the sole breadwinner of a family might die untimely is the scenarios warrants insurance. Next question. Question number 5. Which of the below insurance scheme is run by an insurer and not sponsored by the government? It is run by insurer, that is insurance company, not by the government. What it is? Employer State Insurance Corporation? No. Crop Insurance Scheme? No. Jan Arogya. Jan Arogya is run by insurance company. It is not run by government. So students may choose fourth option, all of the above. Dear friends, Jan Arogya is not government scheme. It is insurance company scheme. So all of the above is wrong. Correct answer is Jan Arogya. Please remember this. Question number 6. Risk transfer through risk pooling is called? What it is? Insurance. Question number 7. The measures to reduce chances of occurrence of risk are known as? What is this? Chances of occurrence. Chances. What it is? Loss prevention, friends. Dear friends, chances of occurrence is loss prevention. Okay? Dear friends, question number 8. By transferring risk to insurer, it becomes possible to enjoy peace of mind and plan one's business more effectively. Is correct answer, friends. Okay, to become careless is wrong. To make money from insurance, wrong. To ignore the potential risk, dear friends, some students may choose this. To make money from insurance in the event of a loss, no, this is wrong. So by transferring risk to insurer, it becomes possible to enjoy peace of mind and plan one's own business more effectively. Question number 9. Origins of modern insurance business can be traced to Lloyd's. What is Lloyd's? Dear friends, Lloyd's is the coffee house at London. In that coffee house, the traders of shipping business agreed to share the losses. So Lloyd's is correct, friends. Bottomry, Rhodes, Malhotra Committee. No, answer is Lloyd's. Next, question number 10. In insurance context, risk retention indicates a situation where risk retention, friends, what it is? One decides to bear the risk and its effects is known as risk retention. Question number 11. Which of the following statement is true? So the question is, they are asking true. Statement is true. Insurance protects the assets. No. Insurance prevents its loss. Insurance reduces possibilities of loss. Insurance pays when there is loss of assets. This is true, friend. So insurance is not going to protect the assets. It is not going to prevent the loss. It is not going to reduce the loss. So what is insurance? Insurance pays when there is loss of asset is correct answer. Next question. Question number 12. Out of 14 houses, each valued at rupees 20,000. Dear friends, there is a mathematical equation or how insurance works. There is a example. Let us see. Out of 400 houses, each valued at rupees 20,000. On an average, 4 houses get burnt every year, resulting in a combined loss of rupees 80,000. Dear friends, there are 400 houses. Each house costs 20,000. If 4 houses are get burnt every year, what is the loss? 80,000. Okay? There are 400 houses. 4 are destroyed by burning. So what is the loss? 80,000. 20,000 into 4 is equal to 80,000. So what should be the annual contribution of each house owner to make good this? So 80,000 divided by 400, 2 zeros are cancelled. The remaining 800 divided by 4 equal to 200. Answer is 200, friends. This is how insurance works. Question number 13. Which of the following statements is true? Question is true. Statement is true. Always remember, few by many. Insurance is a method of sharing the losses of a few by many. Right? So, risk of an individual to an individual, many by a few to the many. No. Answer is, insurance is a method of sharing the losses of a few by many is correct. Okay, friends? Next question. Question number 14. Why do insurers arrange for survey and inspection of the property before acceptance of a risk? Dear friends, insurers go for survey for the inspection of the property because to assess the risk for rating purpose. So to find out how the insured purchased, no. To find out whether other insurers, no. To find out whether neighboring property, no. The question answer is to assess the risk for rating purpose, the survey will be done. Next, question number 15. Which of the below option best describes the process of insurance? Dear friends, few by many is correct answer. Question number 16. A contract comes into existence when? What is a contract? One party makes an offer which the other party accepts unconditionally. Is correct answer, friend. Let us see other answers. So one party makes an offer which the other party put extra conditions. No. Gives counter offer. No. Party receives the offer. No. The correct answer is one party makes an offer which the other party accepts unconditionally. Is correct answer, friend. Next, question number 17. An insurance agent is intermediary between insurance company and IRDA, client and insurance company, client and IRDA, insurance and reinsurance company. Agent is an intermediary between client and insurance company. This is correct answer, friend. One is correct answer. Next, question number 18. Human beings need life insurance because death is certain. Yes, of course. Death is uncertain. No, it is certain. The timing of death is uncertain. Death is certain, but the timing of death is uncertain is correct. So the human beings need life insurance. Death is the solution. No. So the timing of death is uncertain. That is why human beings need life insurance. Dear friends, it is clear. Next, question number 19. In insurance terms, pooling of risk is using the same pool for paying claims of life insurance is known as pooling of risk. Other answers are for paying claims of car and life insurance. No. Claims of life insurance, claims of life and house insurance. No. Different pool for paying claims of life insurance. No. Same pool for paying claims of life insurance is known as pooling of risk. Next question. Question number 20. In life insurance business, if a person is working in calculating premium rates of insurance products, then he is most likely a member of what? Institutes of Actuaries of India. Dear friends, this is very, very important. Actuaries of India. Who will calculate the premium rates? Institutes of Actuaries of India. Right, friends? Insurance Institute of India? No. Chartered Institute of Insurance? No. Insurance Institute of Risk Management? No. So the key word is actuaries. Actuaries, please remember this. It is very, very important question, friends. Next, question number 21. Insurance market divided into life and non-life insurance. Life and non-life insurance. Health insurance also comes under life insurance. Dear friends, you may confuse. Health insurance also comes under life insurance. So the insurance market is divided into mainly two types, that is life and general insurance. Endowment and money back, government and private, health and saving. No. Life and general insurance is known as insurance market divided. So the right answer is 2. Next, question number 22. Life insurance company determine the level of risk based on what? Claim experiences. Dear friends, it is very, very important. Life insurance company determine the level of risk based on claim experiences, that is past experience. Based on that, the company will determine the level of risk. Next, question number 23. The concept of indemnity is based on the key principle that policyholders should be prevented from profiting from insurance. Dear friends, indemnity says profiting from insurance. The concept of indemnity is based on the key principle. What is the key principle? One should not be get profited from insurance. Insurance, insuring existing losses, making false insurance claims, paying excessively for insurance cover. No, friends. The correct answer is profiting from insurance is correct. Some people may choose this, making false insurance claims. Okay, no, this is not relevant to this question. Next, question number 24. What is bank assurance? So bank assurance is selling insurance policies through banks is known as bank assurance. Next question, 25. Amit is looking for term insurance. Term insurance, dear friends, term insurance plan for protection of his family. He is advised to approach to where he has to go. Life insurance, health insurance, liability insurance, property insurance. Life insurance, friend. Life insurance is correct, friends. Next question. For assessing the risk of a group health insurance policy, which of the following information is the most critical? Which is critical? Dear friends, age of the group is most critical. Age of the group is most critical. Question number 27. Insurance business is classified into three main types. So how many main types? Three main types. What are they? Life, non-life, just know what I said, and reinsurance. This is correct answer, friends. Miscellaneous, micro insurance, no, life and non-life and reinsurance. Next, question number 28. Life insurance, the risk is determined on the basis of future data, past data, statistical data, mathematical data. Which is the data they follow? Life insurance, the risk determined on the basis of past data, friends. Based on past data only the risk is determined. Dear friends, in your IC38 exam the keyboard will be deactivated, means you have to use only mouse. Okay friends, by using keyboard arrow marks the answers may be shuffle. The business of insurance is connected with physical economic values of assets. The correct answer is economic values of assets. Suppose I have choose this. So if I use arrow key, the answer is moving down. If I use up key, it is going up. Right friends, the business of insurance is connected with economic values of assets. Next, question number 30. Which of the following do not include the channel of indirect marketing? So what is the question? Do not include of indirect marketing. Dear friends, insurance brokers do not include the channel of indirect marketing is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 31. If 5% bonus is given every year, then for a sum assured of 1 lakh, 5% of 1 lakh is 5000, what will be the payout after 15 years in a simple revisionary bonus system? So 5% each year into 15 5 ja 75,000. So the answer is 75,000, friends. Next, question number 32. If a client wants to compare between all financial products, then the best person he can approach is, where he has to go? Broker, not individual agent, corporate agent or bank. Broker can help him to compare all financial products. Next, question number 33. If insured gets the two advance payment in the 5 years and in the maturity, he gets rest of sum assured. What type of policy it is? Money back policy. Dear friends, this is money back policy. Convertible plan, term plan, endowment plan. No. Money back policy where he will get advance payment in the 5 years and in the maturity he gets rest of the sum assured is known as money back policy. Next, question number 34. In term insurance, if critical illness CI rider claim happens, then what will happen to existing policy? CI critical illness benefit will cease, friends. This is correct answer, friend. 34, critical illness benefit will cease. Next, question number 35. The ombudsman's powers are restricted to insurance contracts of what value? What is the value of ombudsman? 20 lakhs, friends. The answer is 20 lakhs. Answer is 20 lakhs. Next, question number 36. Insured can contact to seek the resolution of grievances they have against insurer to IRDA through what? Complaints at the rate of IRDA.gov.in is correct answers, friends. So if the insured has any problems, to resolve that problems or to seek the resolution of a grievance, then they can go to IRDA through complaints at the rate of IRDA.gov.in. This is correct answer, friends. Dear friends, in your actual IC38 exam, there will be 50 questions and each question carries 1 mark, that is 50 marks. The pass marks are 18 marks, friends. But I have taken 36 very, very important questions from the chapter Introduction to Insurance. Dear friends, in your IC38 online exam, yes, you have option to go back and recheck all the answers. If you are not yet attempted, please tick one answer, even though if you do not know the answer, because they do not carry any negative marking. So please choose the answer which you feel correct. Don't leave blank. So recheck, and if you feel something is wrong, yes, you can recorrect it. For example, you already choose one and now you feel two, then you can go for two or anything. So there is chance to recorrect. the answers. Once you feel all are completed, then simply go for submission button, friends. Dear friends, once you submit, you will not have chance to recorrect your answers. Let us see what happens. Dear friends, once you submit your question paper, you will get result immediately. Let us see. Your score will be displayed on screen. Let us see the score. Dear friends, congratulations. You got 36 out of 36. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching my video. And please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed. And don't forget to leave a comment. And please click like button and bell button to get my latest videos notification. Good morning, friends. Welcome to the series of IC38 IRDAI Life Insurance and Health Insurance Agent Exam. Please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed, and don't forget to click on bell button to get more notifications about my latest videos. Dear friends, today we are going to learn about recently asked important questions from Chapter 2, Customer Care, and Chapter 3, Grievance Redressal Mechanism of IC38. Dear friends, in this exam there are 50 questions. And maximum marks are 50 marks, time allowed is 60 minutes. What are the pass marks? 18 marks. Dear friends, it is expected to get 5 to 10 questions from these two chapters. Let us see the questions. Question number 1. What is meant by customer lifetime value? Sum of costs? No. Rank given to customer? No. Sum of economic benefits that can be achieved by building a long-term relationship with the customer is known as customer lifetime value. Dear friends, what is customer lifetime value? It is a sum of economic benefits that can be achieved by building a long-term relationship with the customer is known as customer lifetime value. Maximum insurance that can be attributed to the customer? No. The answer is sum of economic benefits. Option number 3 is correct. Next, question number 2. Identify the scenario where a debate on the need for insurance is not required. Dear friends, there is no debate. You have to take. It is must in India. What it is? Property insurance? No. Business liability insurance? No. Motor insurance for third party liability? Dear friends, it is compulsory. It is. There is no question of debate. That means motor insurance for a third party liability is compulsory in India. Fire insurance? No. So the correct answer is option 3. Next question. 3. As per the Consumer Protection Act 1986, who cannot be classified as a consumer? Dear friends, there is a act in 1986. What it says? So who cannot be classified as a consumer? So there is a definite definition in Consumer Protection Act 1986. Who is not a consumer? Who is hires goods services for personal use? Yes, he is a consumer. A person who buys goods for resale purpose. So he is not a consumer, he is a reseller. So this is the correct answer. They are asking who cannot be classified. So the resale fellow is not a consumer. Buys goods and services for a consideration and uses them, he is a consumer. Uses the services of another for a consideration also is a consumer. Whereas a person who buys goods for resale purpose, that is resale purpose, who buys for resale purpose is not going to be a consumer. That means option 2 is correct, friends. Next, question number 4. What does not go on to make a healthy relationship? Dear friends, being an agent, if you want to maintain a relationship with your customer, what does not go on means what is not required. Attraction, it is required. Trust, required. Communication is required. Skepticism, dear friends, it is very, very bad habit. Skepticism. So the answer is option 4, skepticism. Question number 5. Which among the following is not an element of active listening? Dear friends, this is very, very important. Customer care. What you have to do while listening? Paying good attention? Yes. Being extremely judgmental? No. This is not a good not an element, this is not a good habit. So being extremely judgmental is the correct answer here. Empathetic listening, yes, it should be. Responding appropriately, yes, it should be. But being extremely judgmental is not an element of active listening. This is correct answer number 2. Question number 6. Which among the following is not a characteristic of ethical behavior? What is ethical behavior? Let us see. Making adequate disclosures to enable the clients, maintaining confidentiality of clients, placing self-interest ahead of client's interests. Which among the following is not a characteristic of ethical behavior? Is not. So these are all ethical behaviors remaining. Whereas placing self-interest ahead of client's interest is not a characteristic of ethical behavior. Placing client's interest ahead of self-interest is a ethical behavior. Whereas placing self-interest ahead of client's interest is not a characteristic of ethical behavior. The option 3 is correct, friends. Next, question number 7. Dash is not a tangible good. Insurance. Dear friends, tangible means which can be physically seen and touched is a tangible, and insurance is not a tangible because it is cannot be seen as a physical matter. That is why the answer is 2. Question number 7, option 2 is correct. That is insurance. Question number 8. Dash is not an indicator of service quality. So what should be there? Being a good service, cleverness, reliability, empathy, responsiveness. These three are required, but it is not an indicator. Cleverness is not an indicator of service quality. The answer is cleverness. Next, question number 9. In India, dash insurance is mandatory. Just now what I said, motor third party liability insurance is mandatory in India. Question number 10. One of the methods of reducing insurance cost of an insured is, so one of the methods available to reinsurance, no, deductible, friends. Deductible insurance makes insurance cost of an insured is reducing insurance, means it reduces the insurance burden or cost of an insured is deductible insurance. Co-insurance rebate, no, deductible insurance. Question number 11. A customer having complaint regarding his insurance policy can approach IRDA. Dear friends, IRDA through which portal? IGMS. IGMS. What is IGMS? Integrated Grievance Management System. It is very, very important, friends. Question number 12. Consumer Protection Act deals with complaint against insurance companies, complaint against shopkeepers, complaint against brand. Dear friends, all these comes under Consumer Protection Act. So the complaint against insurance companies, brand and shopkeepers is the correct answer. Consumer Protection Act deals with complaint against insurance companies, brand and shopkeepers. Next, question number 13. Dash has jurisdiction to entertain matters where value of goods or services and the compensation claim is up to 20 lakhs. Dear friends, it is very, very simple. See, here three forums are given. For example, High Court, it doesn't come. District Forum and Ombudsman comes below 20 lakhs. If the compensation claim is 20 lakhs, then one can go to District Forum or Ombudsman. Okay, friends, if it is above 20 lakhs to below 1 crore, they has to go state commission. Below 1 crore, above 20 lakhs, they are advised to go state commission or state forum. If it is beyond 1 crore, then national commission, that is national forum. He has to go national forum. It is clear, friends? Next, question number 14. In customer relationship, the first impression is created by being confident, by being on time, by showing interest. These are all required for customer relationship. That means by being on time, showing interest and being confident is correct answer, friends. Question number 15. Select the correct statement. Ethical behavior is impossible. No. Ethical behavior is not necessary. No. Ethical behavior helps in developing trust between the agent and the insurer is correct answer, friends. Ethical behavior is expected from the top management. No. Ethical behavior helps in developing trust between the agent and the insurer is correct answer. Next, question number 16. Active listening involves paying attention to the speaker, giving an occasional nod and smile, providing feedback. These are all required. So all are in fourth option, that is paying attention to the speaker, giving an occasional nod and smile and providing feedback is correct answer, friends. Next question, 17. The dash has jurisdiction to entertain complaints where value of the goods or services and the compensation claimed is up to 20 lakhs. Who is that fellow? Where he has to go? District, state, Zilla Parishad, national. District forum, 20 lakhs, district forum or ombudsman. Expand the term IGMS. Just now I said insurance, Indian integrated intelligent. Dear friends, integrated grievance management system is IGMS. Next, question number 19. Which of the below consumer grievance redressal agencies would handle consumer disputes amounting between rupees 20 lakhs and rupees 100 lakhs, that is 1 crore? Just now what I said, state commission is correct answer, friends. Question number 20. Which among the following cannot form the basis for a valid consumer complaint? So consumer complaint, one has to give means what it requires. Shopkeeper charging a price above the MRP for a product, yes, he can give a complaint on this. Shopkeeper not advising the customer on the best product in a category. If a shopkeeper is not advising a best product, he cannot go to consumer forum, because it is all depends on the customer, not on shopkeeper, to choose best product, because shopkeeper is ready to sell all products, right, friends? Allergy warning not provided on a drug bottle, yes, then he can go faulty products, yes, he can go. But shopkeeper not advising the customer on the best product in a category, then a customer cannot go to consumer forum. Next, question number 21. Which of the below will be the most appropriate option for a customer to lodge an insurance policy related complaint? Where he has to go? Insurance, police, Supreme Court, insurance ombudsman, district court. Dear friends, insurance ombudsman is the correct person to lodge a complaint. Next, question number 22. Which of the below statement is correct with regards to the territorial jurisdiction of the insurance ombudsman? Insurance ombudsman has national jurisdiction. Insurance ombudsman has state jurisdiction. Insurance ombudsman has district jurisdiction. Insurance ombudsman operates only within the specified territorial limits. This is correct, friends. Option 4 is correct. Next, question number 23. How is the complaint to be launched with an insurance ombudsman? How to give a complaint to ombudsman? Made in writing, orally in a face-to-face manner, through newspaper. Dear friends, the complaint is to be made in writing. It is very, very important, friends. How is the complaint to be launched with an insurance ombudsman? The complaint is to be made in writing. Writing is correct answer. Next, question number 24. What is the time limit for approaching an insurance ombudsman? What is the time limit? Within 2 years, within 3 years, within 1 year, within 1 month. Within 1 year, friends. Within 1 year of rejection of the complaint by the insurer, one can go or approach to an insurance ombudsman. Next, question number 25. Which among the following is not a prerequisite for launching a complaint with the ombudsman? There is no prerequisite. What it is? The complaint must be by an individual. Yes, it is. The complaint must be lodged within 1 year. Yes, it is. Complainant has to approach a consumer forum prior to the ombudsman. No, friends, there is no requirement. So one can directly go to ombudsman without going to consumer forum. The total relief sought must be within the amount of rupees. Yes, it should be below 20. But the complainant has to approach a consumer forum prior to the ombudsman is not a prerequisite. The answer is option 3 is correct, friends. Question number 26. Are there any fee or charges that need to be paid for lodging the complaint with the ombudsman? Is there any fee? No fee. Don't think. No fee. It is correct answer, friends. Next question, 27. Can a complaint be launched against a private insurer? Yes, friends, it can be done. Yes, complaint can be launched against private insurers. This is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 28. According to insurance terminology, which of the following is correct? There is some terminology. Lung cancer is a hazard, smoking is a hazard, and lung cancer is a peril. Is correct answer, friend. Let us see. Smoking is a hazard. Yes, smoking is hazard, and lung cancer is a peril. Right, friends? Lung cancer is a hazard, whereas smoking is a peril. No, smoking is not a peril. It is a hazard. Lung cancer is a peril. Yes, it is. And smoking is a moral hazard. No, it is not a moral hazard. Smoking is a moral hazard, whereas lung cancer is a peril. Smoking is a hazard and lung cancer is a peril is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 29. An insurance company pools the premium collected from several individual to insure them against a similar risk is called pooling of risk, friend. Don't think pooling of risk. This is correct answer. Pure risk, insurable risk, sharing of risk. There is no terms like this. Just go for pooling of risk. Pool. Next, question number 30. Available loan amount under a life insurance policy is generally based on surrender value. The loan is amount under a life insurance policy is generally based on surrender value. That depends on the surrender value. Next, question number 31. Grouping the similar risks by insurance company is called as pooling of risks. Next, question number 32. Health insurance rider and critical illness rider is classified under life and non-life? No, both life insurance. Dear friends, health insurance and critical illness rider comes under life insurance. So these are non-life insurance, non-life and life. No, both comes under life insurance. Next, question number 33. How are perils and hazards normally distinguished under term insurance policies? Perils are medical factors. No, perils are risk that policyholders will die before a specific date and hazard. And hazards are factors which could influence that risk. Dear friends, in terms of insurance, risk is death. That means the reason behind death is peril. Peril is nothing but the reason behind death is known as perils. That means perils are risks that policyholders will die before a specified date, and hazards are, what is hazard? Are factors which could influence that risk. Influencing factors, just now we saw, smoking is a hazard. Smoking, what happens? That leads to lung cancer. Lung cancer is a peril, leads to risk. Dear friends, smoking is a hazard, lung cancer is a peril. That is how it is implied in insurance policies. Next, question number 34. In case of life insurance, the insurable interest should exist when it should be at the time of taking the policy. Dear friends, this is very, very important. At the time of taking the policy, there must be insurable interest. Next, question number 35. Law of large number is worked out by which of the following? What it is? Pooling of risk. Just remember, pooling. Question number 36. Mr. Kunal used to participate in a car race. Yes, it is allowed. While taking up the insurance policy, he disclosed this information. Very good. What kind of hazard does it refers to? What it is hazard? Physical hazard. What happens? There is a chance of physical hazard. Fraudulent, moral peril. No, physical hazard is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 37. Mr. Mahesh is a software engineer. He has taken a term insurance for rupees 30 lakhs for 30 years. This is an example of what he did? Risk retention? No, he has taken term insurance. Risk transfer? Yes, friends. Risk transfer. Risk avoidance, tolerance? No, risk transfer is correct answer. Next, question number 38. Which of the following can be an example of moral hazard? A family of heart disease, a person working, a person consuming alcohol. Consuming alcohol is a moral hazard. Consuming alcohol is a moral hazard. Next, question number 39. Mr. Shyam is having 9-year-old child. Which product is not to be given priority? Which plan not to be given priority? Health plan, child plan, life insurance, retirement plan. Retirement plan, friends. Health plan, yes, it is required. Child plan required, life insurance required. But retirement plan is not given priority. Next, question number 40. Ombudsman has to give his decision within how many days? How many days, friends? 30 days. He has to give 30 days. Question number 41. On 6th August, there was a typhoon. Mr. Augustine, who had insurance, died in typhoon. Now, how will the insurance company will categorize this particular risk? What is this type of risk? under the category of pure risk. This is pure risk, friends. That is, typhoon is a pure risk. Peril risk, particular risk, risk transfer. No, pure risk. This is an example of pure risk. Next, question number 42. Ram works in a firecracker company, that is factory. He stocks the cracker in his house. He runs which type of risk? What happens if something happens to that crackers? He will lose financial, means there is a chance of financial risk. Speculative, particular, financial, fundamental. Financial risk, there is a financial risk, friends. Next, question number 43. Suresh is suffering from asthma and the policy is being done on joint life basis and the need for nomination under the plan will be as. So the name itself, joint life. The answer is joint life policy. The answer is joint life policy, friends. Next, question number 44. The risk, what does it mean? Contains peril and hazard, level, uncertainty, all of the above. These are all correct, friends. Peril and hazard. The risk means the peril. The risk contains what? Peril and hazard. Yes, level, uncertainty. These are all comes under risk. Next, question number 45. The function of insurance works on risk transfer. Risk transfer. Just avoid retention. No, you are not avoiding. You are transferring. So all of the above. Don't select this. All of the above. So go for risk transfer. Next, question number 46. The Institute of Insurance and Risk Management, along with insurance education, does what more? Regulation, redressal, research, repository. Research, friends. Regulation, IRDA, it is. Redressal, different bodies there. Research, it will do some research. Question number 47. Under the IRDA guidelines for claim settlement and queries or additional documents can ask from the claimant within how many days? 15 days, friends. Don't think. 15 days. Just go directly. 15 days. Question number 48. Vijay received his policy bond on 11th June. That means 11th June 2018. Due to some personal problems, he has decided to cancel the policy on 8th July 2018. Means it is 11th June to 8th July. There is a time gap of 27 days. Can he cancel or return the policy? No, friends. What is the free look period or the cooling period? 15 days only. That means no, as 15 days period is over, so he cannot cancel or return the policy. Question number 49. What is the main objective of taking the life insurance policy? What is the main objective? Why you need life insurance? Dear friends, tax, savings, investment? No. Protection. Protection. Dear friends, life insurance gives protection. Question number 50. With pooling of risks, an insurance company pools the premium collected from several individuals to insure them against similar risks. At what circumstances will the insurance companies pool the risk of a life insurance and health insurance together? Is there any circumstances to mix life and health insurance together? Under no circumstances it will mix. Dear friends, under no circumstances is correct answer. Dear friends, we have completed 50 questions. In your actual IC38 exam, there is a chance to go back and recheck your answers. If you not yet attempted, please attempt or tick some answer even if you don't know the correct answer, because there is no negative marking. It is allowed to recheck. For example, here the question answer is skepticism. I can go for another answer or I can go back to same answer. And please check carefully all the answers whether you have done or not. If not done, please click some answer. Then submit your question paper. Dear friends, in your real exam also, you will be given immediate score. That means whether you are passed or failed, you come to know immediately after submission of your question paper. Let us see the view score, how many we got. Yes friends, congratulations, we got 50 out of 50. Thank you friends. Dear friends, thank you for your support. Please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed, and don't forget to click on like and bell button to get more notifications about my latest videos. Wow. According to new syllabus of IC38, regulatory aspects of insurance agents comes under section 1, that is introduction to insurance. It is very, very important that it is expected to get 15 to 20 questions from this section. Let us see some important question answers from recent exam. Question number 1. A person suffering from lung cancer is a smoker. Here smoking can be termed as, in this case, smoking can be termed as risk friends. If a normal person is smoking, then in that case, smoking becomes hazard. Whereas the person already suffering with lung cancer, in this case, smoking becomes risk friends. Please don't confuse. A person suffering from lung cancer is a smoker, then in this case, smoking becomes risk, whereas a normal person if smokes, that smoking becomes hazard. So the correct answer is risk. Question number 2. According to IRDA agent's code of conduct, what is the best method of showing the amount of commission earned by the advisor? Signed copy of sales illustration, brochure, handwritten declaration by agent, verbal communication to customer. According to IRD agent's code of conduct, what is the best method of showing the amount of commission earned by the advisor? Signed copy of sales illustration. This is correct, friends. Next, question number 3. After doing the need analysis of the client, the agent advised the client to opt for TROP, that is term insurance return of premium product. But the client refused. According to ethical business practices, what will the agent do? Inquire about the refusal from the client, suggest an alternative plan, pass on to the superior, pass on to the other agent. Inquire about the refusal from the client is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 4. Ethics can be defined as those values we commonly hold to good and right. Yes, it is correct. Behavior that is based upon the moral judgments of an individual. Yes, it is also correct. A study of what makes one's own actions right or wrong. It is also correct. That means all of the above is correct, friends. Ethics can be defined as all these. Next, question number 5. For an insurance advisor, churning is bad practice. Dear friends, don't advise churning. It is a bad practice. Next, question number 6. For insurance industry, which association to take steps to develop education and research in insurance? What is this? Life Insurance Council, Life Insurance Corporation, Insurance Institute of India, Institute of Insurance. What is the correct answer? Life Insurance Council, friends. This is very, very important. Life Insurance Council is associated to take steps to develop education and research in insurance. This is the council. Dear friends, Life Insurance Council will take care of develop education and research in insurance. Next question. Question number 7. License of an agent was withdrawn in June 2010 due to malpractice. Yes, friends, it can be withdrawn. He can reapply for his license in after how many years? After 5 years, friends. That is 2015 is correct, friends. Next, question number 8. Mr. David, an agent, had helped Mr. Srinivasan to take an endowment policy on February 2009 as Srinivasan was finding it difficult to pay the premium. So Mr. David is a agent, helped Srinivasan to take an endowment policy on February 2009 as Srinivasan was finding it difficult to pay the premium. Mr. David had advised, David is agent, had advised him to surrender this policy and to apply for a lower premium policy. This is called as churning of the policy. Dear friends, don't go for this. It's a bad idea. Question number 9. Mr. Kelkar, advisor, who advised the customer to close the old policy and take new one. But new policy does not have any extra benefits, but it will give more commission to Mr. Gayaram. This is called as churning. Don't advise this churning process. Next, question number 10. Mr. Sharma is a newly recruited insurance advisor. Yes. To meet his month target, he explains only the good points of newly launched plan to his customer. Here, Mr. Sharma's behavior is unethical. He has to explain all, right? Only the good points explanation is not correct, friends. It is unethical. He has to explain everything, positive or negative. Next question, 11. The code of conduct has been prescribed in India by IRDA. IRDA, this is mother. This is mother of all insurance regulations. So IRDA, please remember IRDA is correct answer, friends. Next question number 12. Under the hospital care rider, what is the payout made? So under the hospital care rider, what is the payout? specified amount multiplied by the number of days the policy holder is hospitalized. So it will be paid by insurer. Right, friends? This is correct. Next, question number 13. When can an insurance company give more than 35% first year commission? When the insurance company is in the first 10 years of operation. This is the case where you can expect 35% of commission. This is correct answer, friends. Question number 14. Which of the following is a non-standard age proof? Non-standard, standard age proof. Yes, PAN card is allowed, certificate of baptism is allowed, certificate from school or college is allowed. Whereas certificate from village panchayat is not allowed, friends. Certificate from village panchayat is not allowed. It is non-standard age proof. Next, question number 15. Which tax rate is applicable in case of client pays the premium of 5000 and suffers illness before maturity? Do you expect there will be some tax? There will be no tax, friends. Just blindly tick nil. There will be no tax. Next, question number 16. Pankaj, being a licensed insurance advisor, has to follow code of conduct provided by Insurance Regulatory Development Authority, Life Insurance Company, Reserve Bank of India, SEBI. Which code? Dear friends, Insurance Regulatory Development Authority is mother, IRDA. IRDA is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 17. Rahul is a licensed insurance agent. As agent, he must carry out his role in accordance with IRDA Regulations Code of Conduct. This is correct answer, friends. IRDA Regulations Code of Conduct is correct. Question number 18. Mr. Shankar, an advisor, sold a term insurance policy and unit linked insurance policy. Term insurance and unit linked ULIP to Amar. Shankar told is an advisor, sold a term insurance, one policy, and second policy, unit linked insurance policy. Two policies sold to Amar. The client who is unmarried. So what about Amar? Is a unmarried guy and has no dependent. Consequently, Shankar's action can be termed as what he did? Overselling of insurance policies. Overselling of insurance policies. So it comes under overselling. This is not advisable. As per ethics of IRDA, overselling is not good idea. Next, question number 19. Which is not unethical behavior in below statements? Overselling of insurance policies is unethical. Underselling of insurance policies, yes, it is unethical. Churning, yes, it is unethical. Explaining all details of the policy to customers is not unethical. It is ethical practice, friends. So the option number 3 is correct. Next, question 20. A professional insurance market carries need-based selling. Dear friends, please remember, need-based selling. A professional insurance market carries need-based selling. Next, question number 21. As an advisor, why is it essential for you to carry out the financial planning exercise with the prospective clients? Individuals do not understand their real needs and cannot prioritize them is correct answer, friends. As an advisor, why is it essential? Because individuals do not understand their real needs and cannot prioritize them. That is why an insurance advisor must carry out the planning exercise with the prospective clients. Next question. Question number 22. Fact finding enables the insurance advisor to identify the what? Client's financial need, client's personal problems, hereditary diseases, social background. Dear friends, client's financial need can be known by fact finding. Next, question number 23. Health insurance policy holder takes treatment in a hospital which doesn't have cashless facility. How the policy holder will get benefited? Need to spend and get claim from the insurer. Dear friends, this is correct answer. First, he has to pay the bill, then he can claim from the insurer is correct. Need to add that hospital has a TPA. Need not to claim, need to switch to the another insurer. No, need to spend and claim from the insurer is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 24. If a person is concentrating more on health plan and retirement plan, then at which stage of life is he in? Young married, young unmarried, young married with kids? No, pre-retirement stage. Dear friends, at the stage of pre-retirement age, one concentrates on more on health plan and retirement plans. This is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 25. In the context of financial planning, how is the difference between real needs and perceived needs best described? What are real needs? Real needs are actual needs, and Perceived needs are based on a client's thoughts and desires. This is correct, friends. Real needs are actual needs, and perceived needs are based on a client's thoughts and desires. This is correct answer, friends. Next question. Question number 26. Manish and Manisha is a married couple with one child. They want to plan for savings, child education and marriage. At the same time, their retirement and protection of income. Which should be their lowest priority? Marriage. Marriage is lowest priority. Remaining savings, education, protection is first important, friends. Next comes marriage. So the lowest priority goes to marriage. Next question number 27. Mr. Raj is married and having two children. Which plan can he take that can cover his whole family? Whole family. Family floater. Family floater is correct answer, friends. Next question number 28. Mr. Shant is in his early 20s and has just started earning. His risk appetite is expected to be low. Answer is low. Next question number 29. Mr. Vinod has lot of inconvenience to reach office every day. So he wants to buy an expensive car when he will have sufficient fund. So this is here Mr. Vinod's need is perceived need. The answer is perceived need, friends. Option 2 is correct. Next question number 30. Mrs. Sheila received some amount out of her husband's death. In such a situation, what will be her prime focus? Where she has to focus? Savings, insurance, investment management, planning of pension. Dear friends, invest management is correct answer, friends. Next question number 31. Perceived needs are those imagined to be important by client. Imagined to be important by client. Client imagines themselves that it is important. This type of needs are known as perceived needs. Next question number 32. Suresh has adequate reserve capital with him and he wishes to protect his income. Moreover, he feels that if he does not die, then he would need the amount. What type of plan should he opt for? What type of plan? Term insurance plan? Yes, he can. Term endowment plan? Return of premium plan? Pension plan? Dear friends, the question is, moreover, he feels that if he does not die, then he would need the amount back. Then what is the plan? TROP. Term insurance, return of premium. That is, return of premium plan is required. Answer is option 3, friends. Next question number 33. Under section 80C, the maximum tax deduction that can be gained for premium paid is in a financial year how much? 1,50,000, friends. This is correct answer. This question can be asked in another form. What is the ceiling of tax exemption under 80C? Here also the answer is same, 1.5. Next question number 35. Where one can approach in case of dispute? IRDA, consumer forum, district forum, national forum. The first option is consumer forum. This is consumer forum, friends. Next question number 36. For his investment need, Ravi has parked funds in equity. Yes, the returns from this form of investment can be categorized as, so equity market, high risk market, high risk market, low risk, moderate risk, no risk. Dear friends, high risk is correct, friends. Next question number 37. In which of the following case there is no defined retirement age? Public sector, private sector, professionals, all of the above. Dear friends, in private sector employees, there is no defined retirement age. In a private sector employees, there is no defined retirement age. Next question number 38. Mr. Ramachandra's son, Mr. Bharat, has just employed as a software engineer. Daughter Anusha has got married now. Mr. Ramachandra is free from his burden. So Mr. Ramachandra is now in the stage of what? His son got job, his daughter got married. Then at what stage he is? Pre-retirement, post-retirement, married with older children, employment stage. Pre-retirement stage. This is correct, friends. Question number 38. Answer is 1. Pre-retirement stage. Next. Question number 39. Need analysis involves identifying financial provision to meet predicted and unpredictable needs. This is correct, friends. Need analysis provides or involves what? Financial provision to meet predictable and unpredictable needs is correct answer, friends. Option 1. Next question number 40. The concept of need-based selling involves selling what company wish to sell, advisor wish to sell, customer requirement is, wants companies to sell. Dear friends, selling what customer requirement is correct answer, friends. The concept of need-based selling involves selling what customer requirement is. Question number 41. The disposable income means, what it means? The surplus amount that can be invested is known as disposable income. Dear friends, it is very, very important. Disposable income means The surplus amount that can be invested is known as disposable income. The amount that can be paid towards one's EMIs, the annual bonus amount, the sum of one's all investment. No, friends, the disposable income means the surplus amount that can be invested is known as disposable income. Next, question number 42. The timing of death is uncertain. Yes, we all know. So when one should take life insurance? At the time of uncertainty, at an early age. At an early age is correct, friends. Any time in life, at the time when advisor takes that decision. No, at an early age is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 43. The younger the age of an individual, the lower their liabilities will be. Option 1 is correct, friends. The younger the age of an individual, the lower their liabilities will be. It is correct, friends. Next, question number 44. Vijay, aged 30 years and married, is the sole breadwinner for his family. Yes, he is saving enough with banks. Okay, as an agent, which need you prioritize first? Retirement, tax planning, financial security need, asset building. Dear friends, financial security, this is very, very important, friends. So he is advised to go for financial security need, tax planning, retirement, asset. No, the correct option is 3. Financial security need is correct, friends. Next, question number 45. What do you mean by double income family? Double income. When both the life partners are earning members of the family, it is known as double income. If wife and husband both are earning, then this family is known as double income family, friends. Don't think a lot. Just go for option 2 is correct. Next, question number 46. Which are the two primary needs of any customer in any point of life? What a customer needs actually? Investment and retirement? No. Investment and protection? Yes, investment and protection. He needs some protection. Investment and savings, investment and life needs? No. The correct option is investment and protection is correct answer, friends. Next, which one of the following is true? Every individual's income and expenditure pattern is same? No. Every individual's income and expenditure pattern is different. Yes, friends, the question is true. So the every individual's income and expenditure pattern is different is correct, friends. They are asking which of the following is true. This is correct. What about others? An individual's income and expenditure has no relation. No, there is a relation. An individual should not keep in mind his income while planning his expenditure. No. So these are all wrong statements. So every individual's income and expenditure pattern is different. So this is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 48. A contract exists between insurer and proposer when a proposal has been accepted by insurer. This is correct, friends. A policy document has been stamped? No. A policy document has been received? No. An insurer has made another proposal? No. A contract exists between insurer and proposer when a proposal has been accepted by insurer. This is enough, friends. So this is correct answer. Next, question number 49. Both the parties to a contract must agree and understand the same thing and in the same sense, which is called consensus and idem, friends. This is correct answer. Both the parties to a contract must agree. Consensus. There must be consensus. Agree and understand the same thing and in the same sense is known as consensus and idem. The option 3 is correct, friends. Next question. Question number 50. Amit has taken a government security bond and has parted with it midway as he required the money with the intention of not getting the interest. He is thinking that interest is not coming, so he want to part with it in the middle of the time. Then what he will going to get? What will he get? Discounted value. Discounted value is correct, friends. Dear friends, we have completed 50 questions. And before submitting this question paper, please go through all the question answers, whether you answered or not. If not answered, please answer all the questions, because there is no negative marking in this exam. Please tick some answer. Even if you don't know the correct answer, please choose some answer which is you feel correct in the sense. Then you can submit your question paper by click on submitting button. After you submit, there is no chance to edit your question answers. If you want to edit some answers, yes, you can edit some answers at this stage, like here. Yes, you can go for option 2 or you can go back to option 3. This is possible only before submission. Then let us submit our question papers. Immediately after submission of this question paper, you will become to know your result. Let us see. Yes, friends, you can view your score. Dear friends, congratulations, you got 50 out of 50 in IC38 IRD agent exam. Dear friends, please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed, and don't forget to click on like button and bell button so that you will get notification about my latest video. According to new syllabus, legal principle of insurance contract is very very important chapter, friends. This comes under section 1, and we can expect 15 to 20 questions from this section. Let us see the questions. Question number 1. Which among the following is an example of coercion? Dear friends, Ramesh threatens to kill Mahesh if he does not sign the contract is correct option, friends. Ramesh signs a contract without having knowledge? No. Ramesh uses his professional standing? No. Ramesh provides false information to get Mahesh? No. Dear friends, Ramesh threatens to kill Mahesh if he does not sign the contract is an example of coercion. So the option number 2 is correct, friends. Next, question number 2. Which among the following options cannot be insured by Ramesh? Ramesh's house, yes, it can be insured. Ramesh's spouse, yes, she can be insured. Ramesh's friend, this is correct option, friends. Ramesh cannot insure his friend. This is correct answer, friends. Ramesh's parents, yes, he can insure his parents, but friends is not allowed to insured by Ramesh. Next, question number 3. Which element of a valid contract deals with premium? What it is? What it deals with? Dear friends, consideration is correct option, friends. Which element of a valid contract deals with premium? Consideration is correct option, friends. Offer and acceptance? No. Pre-consent? No. Capacity of parties to contract? No. Consideration is correct option, friends. Next question. Question number 4. Dash relates to inaccurate statements which are made without any fraudulent intention. What it is? Misrepresentation. Dear friends, misrepresentation relates to inaccurate statements which are made without any fraudulent intention, are known as misrepresentation. Contribution, no. Offer, no. Representation is no. So the correct option is 1, that is misrepresentation. Next, dash involves pressure applied through criminal means. Dear friends, what it is? Criminal means, coercion. Straight away you can choose. Coercion involves pressure applied through criminal means is known as coercion. So the correct option is coercion. Fraud, undue influence, mistake, no. The correct option is 3, that is coercion. Dear friends, coercion involves pressure applied through criminal means is known as coercion. Next, question number 6. Which among the following is true regarding life insurance contract? They are contracts between two parties, insurer and insured, as per requirements of Indian Contract Act 1872 is correct option, friends. They are verbal contracts? No. They are verbal which are legally enforceable? No. They are similar to wager contracts? No. They are contracts between two parties, between insurer and insured, as per requirements of an Indian Contract Act, that is 1872, is correct option, friends. Next, question number 7. Which of the below is not a valid consideration for a contract? Valid consideration, there must be consideration. So which is not valid? Money, yes, it is a valid consideration. Property, yes, it is a valid consideration. Bribe, dear friends, bribe is not a valid consideration for a contract. Jewelry, yes, it is a valid consideration, whereas bribe is not a valid consideration. The correct option is 3. Next, question number 8. Which of the below party is not eligible to enter into a life insurance contract? Life insurance contract, to enter into any life insurance contract, one must complete 18 years of age. That means minor cannot enter into this contract. Option 2 is correct answer, friends. Business owner, yes, he can. Housewife, yes, she can. Government employee, yes, he or she can. But whereas minor cannot enter into insurance contract because 18 years is mandate to complete to take insurance. Option 2 is correct, friends. Next, question number 9. Which of the below actions showcases the principle of Uberima Fides, utmost good faith? Uberima Fides, what it says? Disclosing known material facts on an insurance proposal form is Uberima Fides. Dear friends, lying about known medical conditions, no, not revealing known material facts, no, paying premium on time, no. The correct option is disclosing known material facts on an insurance proposal form is known as Uberima Fights. Next, question number 10. Which of the below is not correct with regards to insurable interest? What it is? Friends taking out insurance on one another is not regarded as insurable interest. The question is not correct. So the keyword is not correct. So friends taking out insurance on one another is not correct. So it is not regarded as insurable interest. Whereas father taking out insurance policy on his son, yes, it is correct. Spouses taking out insurance on one another, yes, it is correct with regards to insurable interest. Employer taking out insurance on employees, yes, it is insurable interest is there. Whereas friends taking out insurance on one another is not correct because there is no insurable interest between friends. Next, question number 11. When is it essential for insurable interest to be present in case of life insurance? At the time of claim, at the time of taking out insurance, insurable interest is not required either at time of policy. Dear friends, at the time of taking out insurance, there must be some interest. There must be insurable interest. Yes, friends, this is very, very important. When is it essential for insurable interest to be present in case of life insurance? At the time of taking out insurance. This is very, very important, friends. At the time of taking out insurance is correct option. Next, question number 12. Find out the proximate cause for death in the following scenario. So Ajay falls off a horse and breaks his back. He lies there in a pool of water and contracts pneumonia. He is admitted to the hospital and dies because of pneumonia. So find out the proximate cause. What is proximate cause? Actual, because of what he died. Proximate cause, what it is? Falling of a horse. Falling of a horse is correct answer, friends. If he did not fall, then where is the question of pneumonia, right? So falling of a horse is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 13. According to Insurance Brokers Association of India, what is the most appropriate relationship between insurer and broker? Insurance broker represent the client. Yes, friends, insurance broker represents the client and the insurer remunerate the broker. This is correct, friends. Next, question number 14. After undertaking financial planning exercise, the prospective client said that he does not have funds for investments. To resolve this query, which skill of an agent would be tested? What it is? Objection handling skills. Objection handling skills is correct option, friends. Listening skills, communication skills, client information gathering skills, no. Objection handling skills will be tested. Next, question number 15. Amit and Rashmi are newly married. Both are working couple. They want to invest their savings of 100,000, that is 1 lakh rupees annually, to build corpus to make down payment for their house 5 years from now. They are planning to buy a house after 5 years. Right. An advisor sold them a unit link product to meet their requirement. This may result in ruining the long term. No, opportunity of new business for advisor is correct answer, friends. Dear friends, an advisor sold them a unit link product, ULIP, to meet their requirement. This may result in opportunity of new business for advisor. Bad reputation, financial burden, no. The correct option is opportunity of new business for advisor is correct option, friends. Next, question number 16. If the client does not wish to proceed with the recommendations right at the moment, the agent should ask for the reason for not going with the recommendation. Agent should ask for the reason for not going with the recommendation is correct option, friends. Insist on taking, no. Should ask for a future date, no. Should review once again, no. Should, the option 2 is correct. Next question. Naresh is married and his daughter Sneha is 3 years old. Which plan can he take? Term and children plan. Yes, friends, he can take term and children plan. Next question number 18. The consequences of these risks which will affect specific individuals or local communities in nature is called as pure risk, no. Financial risk, no. Particular risk. Dear friends, particular risk is the risk which will affect specific individuals or local communities in nature is called particular risk. So the option 3 is correct, friends. Next question number 19. What is the factor which has influence and persistency? Dear friends, in insurance business, there must be some persistency. What it is? Role of agent, yes, it is the factor. Product design, yes, it is the factor. Policy servicing, yes. These three are important factors which has influence and persistency. That means all of the above is correct answer, friends. Question number 19, option 4 is correct, friends. Next. Question number 20. What is the stipulated time frame within which an insurer is supposed to respond after receiving any communication from its policyholders? 24 hours, 1 day, 10 days, 30 days. Dear friends, 10 days is correct, friends. 10 days. Next, question number 21. What key benefit high persistency ratios have on insurance advisor? High renewal income? Yes. Less renewal income? No. Fewer client bases? No. Unsatisfied clients? No. High renewal income will have key benefits on high persistency. This is correct option, friends. Question number 21. Option 1 is correct, friends. Next, question number 22. Which one of the following factor does not, dear friends, keyword does not, help in the persistency? Regular reminders? Yes, it helps. Flexibility of premium payment? Yes, it helps. Dispatching discharge voucher to that customer? No. This factor does not help in the persistency. Continuous servicing of the policy? Yes. So the correct option is dispatching discharge voucher to the customer will not help in the persistency. The correct option is 3, friends. Next, question number 23. Agent who is a licensed intermediary is a legal person to act on behalf of the insurer. This is correct, friends. He is the legal person to act on behalf of the insurer. He is the agent. Legal person to act on behalf of the reinsurer? No. Behalf of the contract? No. Behalf of the legal company? No. Right? A legal person to act on behalf of the insurer is known as insurance agent. Dear friends, option 2 is correct. Next, question number 24. Satish, as an insurance advisor, while recommending to his client Ramesh is not suitable policies, then what he can do? Should advise him to surrender all the policies which are not buy from Satish. Correct option, friends. Next, question number 25. Under which one of the following acts the maximum remuneration that can be given to insurance agents described under Income Tax, Indian Contract Act, Insurance Act 1938? Dear friends, Insurance Act 1938 describes the maximum remuneration that can be given to insurance agents. Is correct option, friends. Option 3 is correct. Next, question number 26. When client declines the recommendation by the insurance advisor, even after resolving the concerns, the advisor should ask for reference who might be interested in financial planning? Is correct answer, friends. Should ask for reference who might be interested in financial planning is correct answer, friends. Persuade the client? No. Should never approach? No. Should do nothing? No. Should ask for reference who might be interested in financial planning is correct. Next, question number 27. Which one of the following is not a benefit? Dear friends, not a benefit. This is keyword, not a benefit of persistency. Dear friends, not a benefit of persistency. Helps the client in achieving goals? Yes, it is. But the question is, they are asking, not a benefit of persistency. Reduction in cost? Yes. Increased client satisfaction? Yes. Persistency increases the client satisfaction. Reduction in cost? Persistence helps the client in achieving goals. But the question is asked is not a benefit. Decreased revenues is correct option, friends. Which one of the following is not a benefit of persistency means decreased revenues. Next, question number 28. Why a building long-term relationship with clients is necessary? Agent has the option to recommending highest commission at any time is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 29. A claim was paid in a policy and it was advertised in the newspaper also. This indicates that the policy was lost. It was assigned? No. It was paid up? No. It was surrendered? No. It was lost. So that is why they advertised in the newspaper also. This indicates that the policy was lost. Option number 3 is correct, friends. Next, question number 30. A missing person will be presumed to be dead only after 7 years. Don't think, friends, 7 years is correct. 3 years, 5 years, 9 years, no, 7 years is the period after which the missed person will be treated as dead. Next, question number 31. Aman has taken a term plan for 20 years. In the third year, he suffered financial crisis due to which he was unable to pay premium within grace period and died after 1 month. The nominee files a claim and is rejected because the policy was not in force. Dear friends, he did not pay the premium within grace period, so the policy will not be in force. So the correct answer is the policy was not in force is correct option, friends. This condition is excluded. The claim is fraudulent. The claim is an elderly claim. No, the policy was not in force because he did not pay the premium within grace period. Next, question number 32. An indemnity bond was signed in a policy when the claim was paid. This indicates that the policy was lost. The policy was lost. It was paid up. It was lapsed. It was surrendered. No, the correct option is it was lost, friends. And option one is correct, friends. Next, question number 33. An individual is said to be competent to enter into a contract if they are 18 years. As per Indian laws, it is 18 years, friends. Next, question number 34. Detailed investigation will be triggered in case of maturity claims? No. All death claims? No. Elderly death claims? Dear friends, option 3 is correct. Rider benefit claims? No. Early death claims triggers investigation in detail. Dear friends, elderly death claims is correct option. Next, question number 35. Family floater health insurance plan covers, it's a family floater means all members of a family. All members of a family. Husband and wife? No. Parents only? No. Children only? No. It covers all members of a family is correct option, friends. Next, question number 36. For tax saving, someone wants to fixed deposit in bank. What duration is required for it? How many years? 5 years, friends. Don't think 3 years, no, 7 years, no, 2 years. The minimum period is 5 years. Then you can grow this FD under tax saving. That is under 80C, you can show this fixed deposit. Next, question number 37. For the customer whose claim has been refused by the company, the three places where he should follow up are ombudsman. Yes, it is correct. IRDA, customer grievance cell, and consumer forum. COPA, SEBI, life insurance council. No, consumer forum. He can approach to consumer forum, ombudsman, IRDA, customer grievance cell, and the third option is consumer forum. The option one is correct, friends. Next, question number 38. Generally, insurance companies do not hold the premium in case of a fraud or misrepresentation. However, due to which of the following circumstances the insurer can retain the premium of the policyholder? Fraudulent claim? No. Indisputability clause. Under this clause, the insurer can retain the premium of the policyholder is correct answer, friends. Redressal procedure? No. Pending decision from ombudsman? No. The option 2 is correct, friends. Next, question number 39. In insurance, if a person is not heard for 7 years, friends, don't think 7 years, he is presumed to be dead. That means 7 years is not seen or not heard, he is presumed to be dead. So the option 3 is correct, friends. Next, question number 40. In the process of settling maturity claims, the process is initiated by the company well in advance of the maturity date. This is correct answer, friends. The company will wait until the claimant comes to office to demand the claim? No. It is the responsibility of the claimant to approach the company? No. If the claimant does not come within a month, the entire maturity amount will be forfeited? No. The correct option is the process is initiated by the company well in advance of the maturity date. This option 2 is correct, friends. Next, question number 41. Insurer will not pay the claim unless the event insured against happens. This is correct option, friends. The event insured against happens. Until this period, he insurer will not pay the claim unless the event insured against happens. The policyholder makes a demand? No. The nominee makes a demand? No. The insurer completes the inquiry? No. The correct option is the event insured against happens is correct answer, friends. Next, question number 42. Mr. Chintamani has taken a policy from ABC company. on 2nd March 2010, but unfortunately, he died on 18th August 2010. His death claim is considered as early death claim. Dear friends, it is early death claim because soon after taking this policy, he died. That is, within 6 months or within 7 months, he died. This death claim is considered as early death claim. So, the option 2 is correct, friends. Next, question number 43. Mr. Bhaskar had taken a term plan for a sum assured of rupees 7 lakhs. He also has an ADB rider worth rupees 4 lakhs. Unfortunately, Bhaskar died in a car accident. Dear friends, Mr. Bhaskar had taken a term plan for a sum assured of 7 lakhs. He also has an ADB rider worth rupees 4 lakhs. That means total is 11 lakhs. Unfortunately, Bhaskar died in a car accident. How much will be the death claim settlement? 7 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 11 lakhs. 11 lakhs, friends. Total 11 lakhs will be paid. This option number 3 is correct, friends. Next, question number 44. Mr. Feroz has taken policy for critical illness worth rupees 1 lakh in health policy. He also has a term plan worth rupees 10 lakhs. Mr. Feroz was hospitalized after he was detected with cancer. Unfortunately, he died after 3 days of treatment. How the claim will be settled? Dear friends, what is the amount he has? Yes, 1 lakh plus 10 lakhs, that is 11 lakhs. Yes, claim of critical illness and 10 lakh from term policy will be settled. So, the claim under health policy maximum will be the 1 lakh and 10 lakhs from term policy will be settled to the Feroz. Then, the option 1 is correct, friends. Claim of hospital charge rupees 20,000, no. Claim will not be settled, no. Claim will be settled as per the instructions of underwriter, no. The option 1 is correct, friends. Claim of critical illness and 10 lakh from term policy will be settled is correct. Next, question number 45. Pure risk is classified under insurable risk. Insurable risk, economic, no. Speculative, no. Financial, no. Insurable risk, friends. Next, question number 46. Under what kind of rider the insurance company pays the treatment cost in the event of hospitalization of the insured, subject to term and condition of the rider? Dear friends, hospital care rider will pay the hospital fee for the treatment cost. So the option 3 is correct, friends. Next, question number 47. Vinay does not want to take insurance on himself. He feels that his family will survive with the funds available in the bank and monthly rentals received from village. This comes under risk transfer, no. Control, no. Retaining, friends. The option 3 is correct. Avoidance, no. The option 3 is correct, friends. Risk retaining. That means Vinay doesn't want to take insurance on himself. He feels that his family will survive with the funds available in the bank and monthly rentals received from village. This comes under risk retaining. So the option 3 is correct, friends. Next, question number 48. What is meant by a claim under insurance policy? A demand to fulfill the policyholder's obligations? No. A demand to fulfill the insurer's obligations, friends. Insurer's obligations. This is correct, friends. Under insurance policy, what is meant by claim under insurance policy is a demand to fulfill the insurer's obligations is insurance policy. Dear friends, option 2 is correct. Next, question number 49. When a policy is lost, insurance company take utmost care while settling maturity claims because the claim may not be genuine. No. The policy may be pledged, the facts were misrepresented, there is no nomination. Dear friends, the policy may be pledged is correct answer, friends. When a policy is lost, insurance company take utmost care while settling maturity claims because the policy may be pledged. So it may be pledged. That is why the company will take utmost care while settling the maturity. So the option number 2 is correct, friends. Next, question number 50. Which of the following falls under voidable contract? Voidable contract, dear friends. Misrepresentation comes under voidable contract. So the option number 1 is correct, friends. Lack of insurable interest, no. Fraud, no. None of the above, no. So the misrepresentation falls under voidable contract. So the option number 1 is correct, friends. Dear friends, we have completed 50 questions. Before going to submission, please go back and check all the question answers whether you have answered or not. If not answered, please tick some answer. Even if you don't know the correct answer, please tick some answer. Or if you feel that this answer is wrong, you can choose other answer before submission. Yes friends, you can recheck all the question answers and please tick all answers. Please answer all the questions because there is no negative marking in this exam. Once you feel all are answered, then only go for submission. Once you submit your question paper, there will be no chance to edit your answers. That is why before submission, please edit your answers up. Please check all question answers whether you answered or not. Yes friends, once you feel all are answered correctly, then simply click on submit button friends. Once you submit, it will show your marks immediately and you will come to know whether you passed or not immediately after submission. Let us see. Yes friends, you can see your score here. Let us see. Dear friends, congratulations, you got 50 out of 50. That means 100%. Congratulations. Thank you friends, thank you for watching this video and please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed and don't forget to click on like button and bell button so that you will get notification about my new videos. All the best to your exam. Bye. Sayonara.